the whole intrigue with the dark side and edgy music, and it's really hard to explain. It's just part of me. I feel most comfortable when I'm doing that kind of music. I can put my all into that sort of music, and I don't know, it's just something that I feel from my soul, you know what I mean? I've always been intrigued with dark things. My favorite color is black. I've always loved vampires, you know, that sort of thing.
I suppose that you're more fascinated by the dark side of life than being a part of it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm a happy girl, you know. There are times when I can be very silly and, you know, a bit crazy. So it's not that, you know, everything I do in my life is like, okay, this is the dark side of things, you know. I'm not a goth in any way, but those things do intrigue me, and I do like, and I can relate to those things, you know what I mean? But I wanted to do it in a way where the song is still very beautiful and a good song, nothing corny and preachy. In my music, you feel a sense of strength and confidence, but it is done a little bit more subtly, which is very fitting to my personality. Even when I work with people, for example, when I went on tour and putting my show together and working with my musical director, at times, because I do have a sort of sweet way and I'm nice to people, he kind of took it for granted, you know what I mean? And I was young, I was 17, and it's like, you know, I don't think you should do this. And I had to, you know, get a little tough and a little bit strong and tell him, look, regardless, I might be young, but I know what I want. This is my show. You are employed by me, so don't get it twisted. And that's what comes across in my music. You feel that strength and that toughness, but it's done in a very sweet way, I guess you can say. When we did One in a Million and Tim came to me with the track with the triple beats and I heard it, I knew that, yeah, definitely was going to change the scope of R&B. It hadn't been done before.
It took a minute to catch on, but when it caught on, bang, there it was.
I was very excited about it because, like I said, you know, I always want to do things that are different, and he gave me just what I was looking for, you know, and that's why we work so well together, and the chemistry is so sick because we're both on the same page, you know what I mean? And yeah, we all knew that that was going to be something that changed music.
It's like it makes you feel like real, just I can't describe it. It makes it sound wide, spacey, like it's just nature mixed in with music. That's so wild. I mean, I always want to do something like that. So, and I did it with a Lil song. It just sounded real, just abstract to me.
He likes to fuse some of the sounds that are popular in Britain with the stuff that we do. So I guess that's why you hear that.
I go out to these couple clubs out of this chart.
Do you think if you use your imagination that there's a chance that black music in a couple of years will be super high-tech in a soulful way that we can't even grasp today?
Well, you know, there's no telling where music's gonna go. That's so hard to predict.
Everybody got their own era of music. I think now I'm at my point with my era of music. I just pray that it lasts long. There's not a lot of people before their time in this game. Everybody just the same old. But yeah, I am before my time.
He's very much like me, where
I go for difference.
Be looked at as innovators.
That's what I go for. I don't go for no type of 2000 or futuristic stuff. I go for what sounds good to me.
You know, he's a genius when it comes to producing music, so you know I can't really say how his mind works and what he was thinking when he made that track.
The lyrics, I always saw in front of me a guy that couldn't get it up, and you followed with the consoling words, dust yourself off and try again.
Well, not get it up. Don't want people to think that's what I was saying. Not that. I was saying that if you want to try to get with me, make me your girl, make, you know, start a relationship with me, that if I don't respond right away, if I may say no, you know, that doesn't mean that there isn't a chance that it could still happen. So dust yourself off, keep trying, and maybe the second time around I'll say yes. that's what it really was about. Oh, when I heard it, I totally fell in love with it. I thought it was very different. I liked the fact that it kind of had that, you know, Middle Eastern kind of sound. And what I liked about it was the subject matter about a relationship, you know, that somewhat in the middle, two aren't communicating, trying to find a resolution to their problems.
Did you feel that this was a track that not too many of today's R&B generation would sort of attack?
When I make my music, I don't think about what other people might do, what they wouldn't do, would they take this on, you know. I like to do things that are different, a little bit risque.
When people started buying my music, that's when I knew that I did what I came out to accomplish, which was to change R&B.
Tim knows, my writers know, that if they come up with something that's a bit out of the norm, that I'll definitely go for it. I like to do things like that. That's always been my way. Baby girl.
What does the word high-tech soul mean for you?
It just means tracks that incorporate a lot of electronics, but then, you know, the song itself brings in that soul and that funk, so it's a mix of the two. It's a very sexual song. What I like about it is it speaks about love and being in a relationship and how it can put you in a euphoric state. And that is what love is like. You know, you're kind of in a daze when you're in love. And I wanted to tell that story on the album. And it's a little risque, but it's done in a very classy, respectful way. And that's what I like about it.
And then you go the other way on Extra Smooth. You don't care about the six-pack.
No. Yeah, and I like that one. I think the girls will like that song because that's what you do when you're with your girls. You know, you sit back. If you go out and a guy tries to talk to you and he's coming on too strong, trying to be extra cool and extra smooth and extra cute, you know, you let him do what he's going to do and he walks away. Your girls are like, oh, my God, you know, did you check that out, please? Am I supposed to, you know, you like talk to you and be your girl, you know? And I love that because that's how girls get down when they're together.
And it's also interesting that J-Dub makes an instrumental musical, more musical version out of Timmy's inventions.
And that's what I liked about J-Dub, because this time I wanted to kind of take it back to when I was younger and tracks were a bit more musical, used a bit more instrumentation, tracks moved, you know, you had a lot of chords. And J-Dub plays a lot of instruments from guitar to piano and all of that, so he was able to give me what I was looking for in that respect. All sorts of music, all the artists that my parents were into, like Johnny Mathis and Luther and Sade and Stevie Wonder, Marvin Gaye, all those artists I love dearly through my parents. My mother sings, so I used to sing with her all the time, and those are the songs I learned, Chances Are by Johnny Mathis.
Chances are you believe the stars.
Chances are, I sing that all the time. I still sing that song with my mother. Oh my gosh, and I'd love to work with Sade. I idolize her, and that would be a dream to work with her, so she listens, hopefully, you know. She'll find out that I'd love to work with her. D'Angelo, someone I'd also like to collaborate with. We tried to work things out for this album, but scheduling just didn't permit it. So those two people right now are the people I'd like to work with.
Do you think that the future of soul music could be how you combine the high-tech soul that you sort of do with the more organic D'Angelo music, soul child school? The combination is maybe the future.
Definitely, like I said before, you never know where music's gonna go, and I don't know what I may want to do, you know, on my next album. I could be in a totally different space than where I was. I definitely will be in a totally different space than what I was in when I decided to, you know, do what I did for this album. So there's no telling what I'm gonna do and where music's gonna go. It's understandable, you know, this is a different kind of music, different kind of sound, but I've always felt that I have the talent. And that I'll always be here, you know what I mean? The way I've handled my career, I think, tells that, you know, I want to have longevity. I want this to be my life, you know. I believe in pacing myself and always being original, and I think that within itself will keep me out here. So I've never, ever doubted the fact that I'll have a really stable career and have the longevity that I've always wanted. Well, what's happened is I've grown up. You know, I was 15 when that album came out. I started recording that album when I was 13 years old, and started taking vocal lessons when I was 9. So I was, you know, my voice was still developing. I could always sing, but I was a little bit more laid back when I was that age. And over this period of time, the 7 years that I've been in this business, I've grown up in a lot of ways, even vocally, and that's what comes through on this album. My signature style is still there, which was how I sang on Back and Forth and on that album, kind of smooth falsetto tone. But with this album, some songs called for a bit more power and a bit more vocal acrobatics, and you know, I was able to do it because I can sing. So I'm glad people see that I can sing and it's not just studio. I sang in church, but I'm Catholic, and Catholic music is a bit different than, you know, your heavy hitting gospel. I'm just not that type of vocalist. That's not something I've ever really wanted to do. I'm very heavily involved in what my songs sound like, what I want to come across in my music, what I want to sing about, and we all, it's a collaborative effort with all of us. We all, you know, I touch on every aspect of it, but I'll never be the one sitting at the board, mixing the songs, putting the tracks together, writing. That's just not me. I wasn't raised or trained to be that. And that's something you really have to want to do, especially if you want to do it well. You know, when I act, I sing, I dance, I put my all into it because I have a passion and I'm driven to do it. And I've never wanted to write, so I don't think I ever will. I've learned and kind of figured out how to live in the public eye and still have a private life as well. You know, there are certain things I won't talk about, and that's for me, and that's my rule, you know what I mean, to kind of keep some normalcy and some sanity, you know, in this world that can be extremely chaotic. So I've actually learned how to handle the two and try to separate the two as much as possible. When you're a public figure, you belong to the public. People want to know about not only your business but your life, so they feel they know you. So that's fine, but there are some things that have to be, you know, just for you. I keep close to my heart.
You seem so damned professional.
I am a professional, you know. I was trained and raised to be such. I remember being very young and going out and auditioning for record companies, and they're like, you know, she's very poised, and you know, that's always how I was, and I was taught to be extremely professional. So yeah, that comes across. It's in my genes. It's in me to survive and to, you know, overcome obstacles. I remember my grandmother telling me, without obstacles there is no growth, and that's so true. The hard times just make you a stronger person, and you can learn from that, and that's exactly what I've done. And I'll meet more obstacles in my life, you know, whether it be personally or professionally, and I know I'll be able to overcome it, so nothing will hold me down. I think the toughest period was when I first came out, you know, being a young 15-year-old freshman in high school and getting used to the life, even though I'd been around it since I was very young and I knew about the industry. It's one thing to see it and know it, but for it to be on you, you know, and getting used to that fame and some of your friends maybe changing and, you know, trying to still be a kid and be in the industry. So that was something for me to get used to. It's a bit overwhelming at first, but I was fortunate to have my family be so closely involved in my career and also have my friends be supportive. But that was, I can even say, a weird period for me, you know, kind of getting used to the life.
Janet Jackson took like 10-15 years to talk about her marriage with James DeBarge. Mm-hmm. Will there come a time when you will sort of talk about this and let it all out?
No. I'm a very private person, and like I said earlier, there are certain things that I keep for myself, and so there are things that I won't talk about and probably will never speak about.
Oh, you're bothered about the speculation?
No, not at all. You know, when I went through my hard times, you know, I still went out there, I toured, I interviewed, and I talked. And so, no, I'm not bothered by it, you know. Like I said before, I've overcome my hard times, so no.
And it all enhances the mystic image around you, really. That's very much a part of your image.
I guess you could say so, yeah. Well, Gladys Knight was a part of the family. She was married to my uncle for a few years. They have a child together, so I definitely, you know, saw Gladys a lot. She taught me a lot when I performed with her, because there was this part of me that was always very shy. And when I sang with her, the first night I came out on stage, I stood in one place and I sang, and then I walked off. And she was like, no, you have to learn how to work a stage. You have to be able to reel in an audience. You know, you have to learn how to perform for them. All of us out here, we're very strong women, very independent women. We know what we want. We know how to get it. And each of us goes about it a different way. Of course, he's the dog. That's what he does. People are amazing. The culture is amazing. R. Kelly is a great producer. He's a great artist. And I respect him. And he's all good with me.
People think that you have been married to him. Is it correct? Is it not correct?
I am not married, to put a rest to it.
Okay. And you haven't been?
I'm not married, and that's it.
You know, it's a thin line. And if you pass that, you could end up losing someone you love.
How was it to work with him? Oh, it was cool. I'm very proud of the first album. He produced a great first album.
Was there a lot of lies floating around about you two?
It was a lot of drama. It was a lot of drama the past 2 years, but, you know, and it was hurtful for everybody, but we all got by it. It was just a rough time.
Is it something that you regret today that you have done?
Regret what? There's nothing to regret. It was a hard time for me. So, I mean, you know, I learned you gotta be strong and you've gotta be, just have strength. I collect sunglasses. Is love behind me, though I need you to
Elia med skön sång från soffan. Johnny Mathis gav henne den lena honungssmaken. And we're gonna bring it out and put it on a bootleg, of course.
Oh, you are the worst. Okay, so it's anything that just comes to my head, whether it could be a song if I wanted to be, huh?
Yeah, it could be a nicely track, it could be a sort
nicely
of...
track.
Whatever. Some freaky stuff, some sweet stuff, some...
Okay, let me think for a couple of seconds.
Yeah, we're here.
Oh, no, no. Let me see. Put me on a spot. Now I'm all wasting time.
Oh. Maybe start with something from the Isley catalog, something that you haven't recorded so far.
Okay, well, okay, I've got one. Is love behind me, though I need you to satisfy me, destiny will prove to divide me, for your
Lias tolkning av Isley Brothers Let Me Down Easy exklusivt i Soul låter så här i original. Så drar Elia vidare.
I go home tomorrow. I leave in the morning.
Okay. Back to Detroit.
Back to Detroit.
Yeah.
Back home.
Keep up the funk.
I will.